Hello everyone, today I'm going to be showing you how I made this scene in Blender. The first thing I did was gather references for modeling the windmill. The modeling was pretty straightforward, mainly scaling and extruding cylinders. I tried to make sure the proportions were generally accurate, so I made sure to keep an eye on the references. I didn't worry too much about the details because I knew it would be seen from afar. I mainly focused on the general shapes and then added some details here and there. For the blades, add a plane, extrude, adjust the shape, extrude again, scale, extrude again, and rotate. Move the blades to its place, and make sure to adjust the proportions if necessary. Duplicate, rotate again, and look at that, you have a finished windmill. For the car I use this transportation add-on, but you can find free one on various websites. I changed the color to black, then I adjusted the position to get the general idea. But later on when I worked on the composition, I adjusted it further. Speaking about composition, I changed the aspect ratio to 4x3 to give it a more vintage look. I used the golden ratio composition guides. As you can see, the horizon line goes according to the golden crop, and you could see the second windmill hitting the crop as well, which in my opinion is what brought the whole piece together. For the ground, I had two planes, one for the animated grass and one for the static grass. The animated grass was up close and near the windmills. I animated the grass using this geometry node setup, which is mostly based off of Southern's tutorial on animating grass. I went back and forth with the speed of the grass until I got what felt right. Then I added a wiggle animation to the car using a noise modifier. Then I made the windmill spin using a generate modifier and a little bit of noise to add a slight variation. Then I offsetted the animation for the rest of the windmills. I added some camera shake to make it seem more natural. And the staircase and door. Here's a quick tip before we move on to compositing. Using the wireframe modifier, you can make fences. Just make sure to add geometry to wherever you want poles and bars. Moving on to compositing. For the black and white, I used this setup in Blender, but I made sure to make an extra output for the color. Then in After Effects, added a glow, then a little bit of Gaussian blur just to remove the perfection of 3D. Then lastly, added film cover to add grain and final color adjustments. I pretty much did the same thing for the color one, but I just removed the glow. Here's a closer look at the settings. I mainly just changed the color of the midtones to a little bit of a warmer color and adjusted the curves a little bit. And that's it. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial and learned something new. If you have any questions, please let me know down in the comments.